In this video, I'm going to cover some structural foundational updates made to our ESS portal application with version 4.4. A few of our tables we've basically extended to be part of the application file record. And what that implies, or what that means, is that a couple things have changed. One is our card object records, for example, used to be shipped as a separate update set. Now they're packaged in and loaded in as part of the installation. And the way this is done is if we go look at the table, we'll now see that it's extended off the application files. This means that, in essence, we can package the actual records themselves as part of the application and load in successfully. It also means that if we go in and make any edits to any of these records, such in this case, make a simple edit to these, this card object record, that in tune will be recorded to an update set. Right? So those records will be part of the update sets and can be migrated from one environment to the next. The other tables that are included in this are now our card actions record, our card attributes, the card filters, card objects, as I mentioned, the card object views, the card types, and the navigation tiles, as well as this new table we've created for user criteria associated to card types and the suggestion scripts. What's not included that's still kind of outstanding are these decision branch records. These still are separate kind of data records. And then in addition, decision branch records can link to expert records, which are also still considered data records. Now, one of the main reasons I wanted to introduce this platform level update is primarily for existing customers that are looking to update the application from, say, a previous version, 4.2, 4.1, 4.3 to 4.4. There's some challenges in making that update, and I've highlighted them here in this kind of a notice document. It's also in our install and config documents, a section on kind of how to procedurally handle the database schema changes from moving from an old version to a new version. And let me cover them quickly just looking at the document. So what will happen, or what the reason for this, is again, schematically, those tables are now being extended from the application file, whereas in the past they were not. So when they get updated as part of the update process, what happens is that the structure is changed and that the data that's currently in those tables basically gets hidden. And so one of the things you'll see on the screen is a bunch of error messages. And this is the result of trying to, say, load in and export of that data back into the table because it looks like it's empty, and then getting duplicate key errors because in fact the data is indeed there. You just can't get to it or see it through the application API level. So the way to handle it, and I'll just kind of talk through the procedure real quickly here, is those tables that are now being extended from the application table, what has to happen is that before you update the application, so before applying the application update process, each of these tables, you should export the data into an XML for each of these tables, as well as delete all the records that are in those tables. And I'll cover this in a second. So in essence, what you want is a blank record or blank table for each of those before you update, so that when it updates those versions, that data doesn't get hidden and caused to be duplicate. So the way you would basically do that is you'd go to, say, the card objects table. You would then say, I want to export this to XML, download this file, save it somewhere, click all these records and say delete, and then do that for all of the tables listed in this update procedure. And then all those tables should be blank. Then you can apply the application update as part of that. But before you do that, the other thing that happened is on previous versions of our application, we had you go in and make a simple update to the card object table to, in essence, load in a class field. So now this card object record is going to, in essence, be kind of an older version of it. So what we want you to do as part of this update process, I'll highlight here, is we want you to go back to the card object record and specifically the version history of it and revert it back to its original store version. And what this is going to do is it's going to allow on the application update the ability to replace that table. It's not going to view it as a kind of skipped or customized version. So when you come into this link that's in this procedure, you'll see it's got basically a version history, our current record that was edited, as well as the original store version. So what we want you to do is come in here and say, revert this to this store version prior to doing the update, so that when we run the update process, it'll replace this database table with the new scheme, the proper schemed table that's now extended from the application, and allow those updates to come through successfully. One additional thing I want to cover in this video that we changed structurally is instead of using the server storage table for a whole lot of different objects, we're now primarily using it for some of the collections or data collections, like the list of catalog records or the list of data that's displayed on the knowledge page. And so what you'll find is that almost all these card object types now, say our catalog items here, don't have this use server storage turned on. And so by default, we're not storing these in the server storage table anymore with version 4.4. You can still do it if you want to turn it on. There's some options to say, hey, I want to store this record in the server storage table. And I can also choose whether I want to exclude it from being rebuilt nightly or the records of that table being rebuilt nightly. But by default, we're basically kind of abandoning some of the server storage for the individual records and letting them be queried and loaded directly to get more of a current view of these particular data and tables. So that covers what I wanted to cover today in this video. Hope this was helpful in being able to see some of the platform updates that were made with 4.4, as well as the implications and how to apply those with an update from a previous version. Thank you.